In this lesson, we will look at the power behind connecting Dynamo within Revit to an external program, such as Excel, to be able to extract and manipulate data from the Revit environment. By the end of this lesson, you will have an understanding of how to collect Revit room data, how to prepare the data for export, and strategies for ensuring data remains consistent for the import process at a later time. To get started, we will open the sample file included in the dataset for this lesson. This project is simply the Revit Advanced Sample Model with a few modifications made. With Revit open, we will go ahead and load Dynamo, which is available under the Manage tab, Visual Programming panel. At this point, we'll go ahead and start a new blank workspace by clicking on the New icon. Additionally, we'll ensure that our Dynamo is running in automatic run mode at this time. To recap, that's available in the bottom left-hand corner of the Dynamo user interface. You are also able to customize this to where it remains permanent between Dynamo restarts in the Dynamo menu, the Preferences menu, and you can choose your default run settings. In my case, I have it on automatic, but you can choose manual as well. As mentioned, this sample model has some modifications done to it for this example. In this case, some of the room elements are misspelled on purpose. We're going to use Dynamo connected to Excel to spell check these items. Looking at this model, you can see that conference is misspelled, storage, and several others throughout the model. Back in Dynamo, since we are working with rooms in the sample model, we need to first collect the rooms. When we're using Dynamo within another platform like Revit, we gain access to new categories. In this case, we now have access to a category titled Revit within the library. For the collection of Revit elements, we're able to navigate to Revit, Selection. Within Selection, we have access to every method available to us to collect elements from the Revit model. In our case, we're going to go ahead and look for a node called Categories, select it to place it, and another node called All Elements of Category. These two nodes work together to collect elements by the related category. For the Categories node, we will go ahead and select Rooms. By clicking on the dropdown, we can type in the letter R to navigate to the R section and find the category Rooms, and we'll select it. With that dropdown selected, we will notice that we have an output of Rooms. The output type of this node is Category. We will also notice that the input type for the All Elements of Category is Category as well. Let's go ahead and connect these two nodes now. With these nodes connected and us being on run automatically, we are seeing all of the rooms from our current Revit model being selected. As mentioned, we want to perform a spell check on the room's names. With that in mind, we need to retrieve that data. Within the Revit category, in the library, we're able to navigate to various Revit classes to check what properties are available to us. Classes are similar to their respective categories within Revit itself. Walls, floors, roofs, rooms, family instances, and more. Let's navigate to Revit, Elements, and Room. Within this view, we see different categories available to us. The green category indicates creation options. The yellow category indicates actions that we could commit on the objects, and the blue category gives us options for data that we can query from the elements. In our case, we want to extract the room names, so we can go ahead and place this name node now. With this node placed, we can go ahead and drag it to the right and connect our rooms into it. While we're at it, we're going to go ahead and group some of these nodes. So the categories and all elements of category node, we'll select those and use our keyword shortcut, Control G, to group them. We'll title this Collect. We'll add the description as Rooms or Export. I'm going to make this group a different color. You can choose any color that you'd like. At this point, this data can be exported to Excel with the room names, but we want to make our graph more complete for when we import the data back into Revit. So we need to extract the piece of data that remains consistent and is retrievable at a later time. In Revit, every element has a property called element ID. This is the element's standard identifier that allows us to select the element. You can see the element ID in the Revit interface by first selecting an element and navigating to The Manage tab, the Inquiry Panel, IDs of selection. At this point, you will see the element ID for your selected element, and you are also able to select elements by their ID. Both of these options are available in Dynamo. Selecting by ID is something we'll cover in the next video. Back in Dynamo, we need to retrieve these IDs. Once again, this option is available in the Revit category, the Elements subcategory, and since element IDs are something every Revit element has, they're available in a subcategory called Element. Navigating down to the Query option, so this blue category, we have a node called ID. In Dynamo for Revit, we have access to options that are available to all elements in Revit and not specific to various classes. Element IDs are a great example of this because they exist for all Revit elements. Let's go ahead and drag this node over to the right above the room name. At this point, we'll go ahead and hold down Control on our keyboard and duplicate the rooms into the element ID node. Clicking in a blank spot of the workspace finishes this change. We hover, we will see that we've extracted all of the element IDs. Another thing to keep in mind is anytime you're working with elements inside of Dynamo for Revit and the element is part of the output, you will see a green element ID that is selectable. In this case, our All Elements of Category node is outputting elements. The corresponding element IDs are shown with a green highlight. At this point, we need to combine this data to be able to export it to Excel. In order to combine multiple lists of data in Dynamo, we need to use a node called List Create. Let's go ahead and search for this now by right-clicking in our canvas. Typing the word list should surface some results. In our case, the first result is List Create, so we can go ahead and select that now. The List Create node is a UI node that allows us to add more inputs easily. Since we are dealing with two lists of data, we can go ahead and click on the plus sign to add one more input port. As mentioned at the beginning of this lesson, the ultimate goal is to export this data to Excel. At this point, let's go ahead and connect our element.id node to the item 0 input and our room.name to the item 1 input. We'll go ahead and group these nodes as well. Select the nodes, press Ctrl G on your keyboard, and we'll give it a title. In this case, I'll title it Extract, and the description would be Room Data. As mentioned at the beginning of this lesson, the ultimate goal is to export this data to Excel. Excel nodes are included in Dynamo, and they're available under the Import-Export category. We'll navigate to Import-Export Data. In addition to the nodes that require Excel to be installed, Export to Excel, Import Excel, Dynamo also includes additional Excel-related nodes that use an open framework known as Openxml. In this lesson, I will be using the online version of Excel, so I will be using the Openxml nodes. If you have Excel installed on your system, you can definitely use the Export to Excel nodes that require Excel to be installed. I'm going to go ahead and place the Openxml Export Excel node. And we'll zoom out and place this node to the right of our current graph. As you can see, this node requires a few different inputs, three of which are required and not fulfilled, four of which are already fulfilled for us. The first input is the file path input. This is a file path for where we want to write the Excel file. The second input is the sheet name. This is the name of the sheet that the data will be written to. Our third required input is the data itself. This would be our element IDs and room names. The rest of the inputs are optional and already fulfilled for us. These include start row and column, which are integers and represent at what point you want the Excel file to start writing. By default, they are 0, which means that your data will start in the upper left-hand corner of the Excel file. We have an option to overwrite existing files with the Boolean, and we have an option to force it to write as strings, which are text. This comes into play when you're writing numerical data to Excel. Let's go ahead and fulfill the three required inputs that we need. For the file path input, we'll go ahead and search for a node called file path. We'll drag this over to the left. The file path node is special because we can use this node to create a file from scratch. In my case, we can go ahead and click on browse. I'll navigate to my desktop. You can save this file at wherever you would like. I'm going to go ahead and create a new file called revitdata.xlsx. Clicking on Open will fulfill that file path for us. The file path node is a really quick way to do this. With that complete, we'll go ahead and connect this into the file path input. And at this time, we'll go ahead and switch to the manual run mode as well. We'll switch to manual run mode because we are writing data out from Revit, and I want to do that whenever I press run. Once again, we'll navigate to the bottom left-hand corner, select automatic, and change it to manual. For our sheet name, we need to specify what sheet we want to write to. In order to do this, we'll right-click and search for a node called string, and we'll name the sheet room data, plug that into sheet name, and the data input simply takes the data that we extracted. So we'll go ahead and connect our list create node to the data input. At this point, if you press run, you will notice the file get created wherever you chose. Once again, I chose my desktop, so we will see that file exist on my desktop, revitdata.xlsx. In Excel, we can now run a spell check on these. So I'll go ahead and open the Excel Online variant of Excel, drag my Excel file in, and we could start to see our data. As you can see, the data came in by default as rows. A lot of times this isn't desirable. We'd rather have columns. So let's go ahead and look at how to fix that now. Back in Dynamo, we're able to do this by adding one additional node after the listCreate node. This node is called Transpose. So we'll go ahead and search for this node, and then we'll observe the properties of the node. If we hover, you'll see that the description of this node is swaps rows and columns in a list of list. So all this does is flip those rows and columns for us. In this case, we'll go ahead and connect the list create to the input, and we'll connect the output to our data. This is a really handy way to reorganize that data when you're exporting to something like Excel. We'll click run once again, and we have an updated Excel file available to us. In this case, I'll drag it into Excel Online. It will upload, and we'll see the changed Excel file as columns. So now you can see that our first column represents the element IDs of the rooms. The second column represents the room names. At this point, we can go ahead and do the spell check process by navigating to the Review tab, Check Spelling button, and we'll see that we have a few misspellings within this file. We can go ahead and navigate through and change all of these room names that were misspelled. And once that's complete, we're all set. We can go ahead and do a file save if you're in the desktop version of Excel, or a save as, and download the file onto your computer. There we have it. We've exported our data from Revit to Excel and ran the spell check on it. In the next lesson, we will look at how to bring this data back into Revit. To recap, in this lesson, we covered how to collect Revit elements in Dynamo by category, how to extract data from the elements, and how to export that data to Excel. Additionally, we covered how to transform that data from rows to columns. With that complete, I encourage you to continue on to our next lesson, where we will look at how to ingest this corrected data back into Revit and update the room elements.